Alright guys, welcome back to Heavy Rain. So, instead of doing a whole nother playthrough like I was originally planning, we're just gonna go to chapters. I'm gonna go to the last relevant chapter that there was, which was the killer's place. And we're just gonna do what I need to do in order to get all of the endings. I will still go through on specific parts, and show you guys how to get trophies. I still plan on getting all the trophies in the game. However, it will only throw me off to go too far back. So we're just gonna start where I need to start. And that is the killer's place. Now this time we are going to save Madison after she gets trapped by Scott. Now if you go forward and R1, L1, there we go.
What's your touch, girl?
Open.
The Origami Killer's apartment. There must be something that'll tell me where Sean Myers is.
Okay. Now if we go right back here, as you guys know. Open this.
A cop's uniform. Always trust a cop. That's why children went with him. He was dressed as a cop.
Move those back like we did before. We open this up. And if you walk right over here, again, we need to find the password. Again,
shit,
we need to put the password,
password
in and everything. None of those are it, obviously. Again, none of those are it. And... oh, damn it, wrong one. Wrong one!
How does this twisted fuck's mind work? Gotta be something related to his childhood. What did he call those paper dogs when he was a kid?
He called them Max.
Got it. Max. The name John gave to his paper dogs when he was a child. What the hell is that? An address. It's gotta be where Sean Myers is. Hurry. There's no time to lose.
Okay. So... when we try to leave, he pulls a gun on us like before.
So you found my little secret.
Obviously.
Oh, Scott. All those children killed just to find a father capable of saving his son?
Shut up!
You don't understand.
There's one child left. There might still be time to save him. Let him go. Do what your father couldn't do.
Okay. Now what we're going to do is pretend like that's an option. Now we pull this out and we go right there. Try again. And just There we go. Now, R1 triangle and R2. Now, we open the door. We need to get to the kitchen. Now, I'm going to try to navigate her through this place without burning her, but the screen's kind of dark, so I'm not really going to guarantee anything. The important thing is that she gets out alive. Okay, now we move this way. Or no, wrong way. Come on, move. Where am I? Oh, I'm still in the bedroom. For some reason, I thought I was out in the living room / office area. Don't ask me why. Okay. Come on, Madison. And jump. There we go. Now, we can't leave out this way. He locked the door on us. Well, can we? Nope. Okay, we can do that until she dies, but I kind of need her to live. There's no way to escape through there, no matter how many times he kicked that stupid door. Now, need to take the if you open this up and stand on the ledge, you can make it a point where she won't die. An open window right there. See? That's one of the ways you can save her. You can also jump in the fridge, and you actually get a trophy for that, but we'll do that in another part. I wanted to show you guys different ways to save her. Okay.
I know where Sean is. I've got to tell Ethan.
You can call Ethan, but it doesn't really matter. He already knows. So does, Norman. Doesn't really matter who you call. Thankfully, her motorcycle's still there. I'll probably end up doing a longer playthrough a little later, because there are certain parts we have to go back kind of far. This wasn't one of them, and I already met almost all of the requirements anyway. That's why I did this. I'll do a longer one later, but I probably won't ever start it from the very beginning on another playthrough again. Okay. Walk right across there, Ethan. There you go.
I've been looking for a long, long time, Ethan. Looking for a father that would be able to do what mine could not do. Sacrifice himself in order to save his son. Oh, I searched. Searched. And then I remembered you.
And yeah, we've already seen this part. He's standing there, he's watching, and then he stalks them. For a couple of
just
years.
To find a father capable of saving his son.
Just to find a father? Do you have any idea how it feels to be a worthless nothing in your father's eyes? Believe me, I've suffered just as much as my victims.
Actually, you made your victims suffer more because there were some fathers that actually did try to save their son, and they were physically incapable of doing it. They bit one of them in the butterfly trial. I've never found it, but you find someone dead that was clearly a father of one of the others. And he died because he couldn't find a way out. He was willing to die to save his son, but he was physically incapable of doing it. So anyway, we gotta save Sean again. Where is the pole? There it is. Grab that. And we do it again. Yay. Out. And then perform CPR. Okay, and this time, instead of just letting Norman die, we are actually going to fight the origami killer. Okay. Looking for prompts. There we go.